Kia ora tātou. Welcome to the Town Hall on the most special day of the academic year, Graduation Day. Before we begin the official ceremony, I have a few announcements. Firstly, could you please take a moment to turn off your cell phone? We are required to make you aware of the emergency exit procedures. In the event of an emergency, the ushers will assist you to the nearest exit, which are at the side and at the rear of the hall. If at any time you need assistance, there are ushers on hand to help. The program you have outlines the ceremony. At the end of the ceremony, we sing the national anthem, first in Maori and then in English. The words are in the back of the program. The cap and ceremony itself includes approximately 300 graduands. At least one of those is the very reason you have come today, and your graduand will be up on the big screen behind you so that you have a great view regardless of where you are seated. We would appreciate you not leaving until the ceremony is over. Shortly, the organ will play as our staff process in. Then we will hear the call of the karanga, welcoming graduands into the hall. Please stand for their entrance and remain standing until our council chair invites you to be seated. Following the ceremony, please join us for refreshments being served in the supper room. Finally, it is wonderful to have you with us today. Enjoy this special time with Unitec.
Thank you. te minenga, te iti, te rahi, kua rāhiri mai, ki tēnei tō tātou whakaruru hou. Kuhu mai rā, I raro I ngā mihi mahana o Wairaka.
To everyone assembled here in this special building, I extend warm greetings on behalf of Unitec.
Ko tēnei te wā o te pōtaitanga, te whiwhi tohu, ā, ko tātou he manakohia, he whakanui a rātou nei tū, I runga atamera.
This is a time of graduation, of receiving qualifications, a time for celebrating success and achievements of all who will parade proudly before us this afternoon.
Kia katahi ai tātou I roto I te harikoa, te ihi, te wana, ka utaina ki runga, na akonga katoa.
Let us all be united in the sharing of excitement, jubilation, joy and happiness for all recipients.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, kia ora tātou. A very warm welcome to all graduands, diplomates, and certificate recipients, and to family and friends who are here to support you. Not that you need much support, you need celebration. A warm welcome also to honoured guests, especially Unitec fellows, members of council, and Unitec staff. And finally, welcome to our guest speaker, Saul Taylor. I am Lee Mathias, and this is the first time, actually it's the second time I did stand here this morning, that I've stood before you as the council chair. So I feel like I'm graduating a little bit myself. And I share something of your nervousness and excitement. Graduation is such a magic day. Unitec is hugely proud of what you have done. Think back to when you first started lectures. How did you feel? A bit apprehensive, a bit doubtful, and now look at the result. You took the challenge and you have succeeded. Enjoy every moment of this ceremony because you deserve it. 309 of you are graduating today in a range of fields from business to health to sport. It is a great achievement. It seems to be quite a time of celebration quite right now, with events such as the Commonwealth Games still fresh in the mind. It was New Zealand's second best gold medal tally. It's hard not to liken the medal haul from the Games to the current number of Unitec graduates. Did you know in the history of the Games, New Zealand has won a total of 609 medals? We have 637 graduates in our two ceremonies today. I have another homegrown example of achievement for you. In July, two of our ITAB apprentices, Josiah Plurg and Elijah Alexander, competed in the World Skills New Zealand National Competition held at the Waikato Institute of Technology. They were the first carpentry competitors to represent Unitec in a decade. We are proud to announce that Elijah took third place overall and Josiah came within a whisker of coming fourth. I'd like to acknowledge the fine work of Colin O'Gorman and Laurie Richardson, who coached those apprentices. You are graduating today, but this is just the first step and hopefully a long journey. Learning will come from more than just the formality of getting a degree or a diploma. Flexible practice and flexible thinking will become the norm. I don't know if any of you saw Nigel Latta's program on education recently. He pointed out that when he was young, students were taught to produce the same things identically, as though they were in a production line. That is no longer the case today, thank goodness. Individuality is cherished, but with that comes the need to be open to change. So rather than thinking this is the beginning of a wonderful career, instead think this as the beginning of your working life, which is likely to change in wonderful ways. Ways that you cannot begin to imagine even now. Technology is driving much of that, so don't be frightened of change. Education is ongoing. It is a lifelong process. You are qualifying in a field that you might not even stay in. This could be just your first career. You may end up having three or four careers in your lifetime. So keep your eyes open. Don't sit back. Keep an open mind as to changes and developments, because the field you are in is very likely to change and change quickly. This is challenging and exciting stuff. Contribution is one of my pet themes in life, allied to work and health. I cannot emphasize enough the benefits of effort. You can already see the results of that today by virtue of your graduating. Work gives you a life. It allows you to live well and have fun. But above all, it allows you to make a contribution to society. Good health determines how involved you are in society. I'm talking about both physical and mental health. With a level of well-being comes interaction, a feeling of being able to make a positive contribution. Graduating today is the first step. My background is in health. We have 53 graduates in that field today. Originally, I qualified as a nurse, and I then became involved in biotechnics and in medical technology. The pace of change and advance in this field is unbelievable, but it can sometimes lead to a disconnect between creativity and deliverance. Here's an example. Auckland University has a wonderful engineering school with very good tuition in the area of theoretical robotics. But nobody teaches us, or people, students, how to make the bits that make up the robots. There is no practical engineering course in this country that covers the tooling up process for the componentry required. In my field of medical diagnostics, we microprint with robots. But we can't get the robots to be made in New Zealand. We couldn't even find anybody in Europe to build components for us. It's actually being done out of a garage in Seattle, the home of Microsoft, so that's okay, I think. The sort of niche, higher-end skill Unitec is aiming to provide. There are such exciting possibilities and opportunities for graduates coming out of institutions like ours. It's the same story in IT. We don't produce enough programmers and systems architects. Rod Drury's company, Xero, for example, just cannot get the programming staff it requires. Xero is having to source large numbers of programmers offshore. This is the type of expertise our own workforce could and should be providing. This is the direction in which Unitec is moving, and you are very much part of this. It's exciting. Unitec's job is to prepare people for work in the New Zealand environment and economy, to respond to what industry needs now and in the future. In some respects, we have an advantage over other universities because our tuition is less theoretical and more practically based. There is such a need for high-end practical intelligence. One of the things we hope to do is to encourage as many of you as possible to stay in New Zealand and to use your skills to contribute towards an exciting economy and a wonderful society. Don't run away, industry is just going to love you. In the words of the great Maya Angelou, success is liking yourself, liking what you do, and liking how you do it. Celebrate today, and tomorrow start responding to new challenges. But remember, opportunities don't just happen. You have to create them. Go forth and conquer. Thank you. And now it gives me great pleasure to welcome our guest speaker, Saul Taylor. Saul is the personification of passionate achievement, whether in endurance sports or teaching. Saul completed a BA Honours in English at Loughborough University in England, followed by postgraduate teacher training at Durham, and then postgrad deaf teaching, at Manchester. If that wasn't enough, he crossed hemispheres and graduated with a first-class honours master's in educational leadership and management from us at Unitec. Saul's dedication to training and teaching is legendary. With typical modesty, he says he felt privileged to have had the Loughborough Athletic Union Hour of Power Award named after him. His next challenge comes in January when he heads to the Himalayas. Watch this space. Saul Taylor.
Good afternoon. Thank you to the Unitec Council members, Dr. Lee Mathias, Dr. Rick Eade, and distinguished academic staff. Kia ora to the families here today, and of course, all of you, the Unitec graduates. What a privilege to be invited along to share your special occasion and wish you all the very best on your achievement. You've done it. And what a wonderful stage worthy of the occasion to receive your degree. I've walked across this stage a few times in my life, twice at Unitec ceremonies and once when I proudly became a New Zealand citizen. Each time I remember waiting at the side of the stage for my name, hoping my walk across would go smoothly. Perhaps you're feeling the same. My advice is don't worry, you'll be fine, enjoy it, and be yourself. So here we all are, proud parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, doubtless some have traveled far and wide to see you get your degree and share your special life achievement. To the proud families watching, congratulations and well done to you too on all the support along the way. All are immensely proud, as are your academics, who will applaud each and every one of you as you make your way across here. I am also here to share with you the passion for what I do and where Unitec has helped to take me in my career. So as a teenager, I volunteered as a summer camp leader, and one of the children in my group was deaf. This sparked an interest in sign language that has never left me. After qualifying as an English teacher and teaching a few years in the mainstream, I specialized and became a teacher of the deaf. Arriving in Auckland in 2006, I held a suitcase in one hand and a job offer with Kelston Deaf Education Centre in the other. In 2009, I enrolled at Unitec and had an amazing 4 years as I completed my master's in educational leadership and management, although originally I was intending to do a one-year certificate. When I first arrived at Unitec at the Department of Education, what appealed to me was the down-to-earth, well-organized, friendly staff and the brilliant mix of theory linked to the real world. From the start, I was in a place I felt welcomed and comfortable, and what I studied directly helped me with my job. It was those interpersonal relationships, the special atmosphere that Unitec brings to the student experience that kept me going from one rung to the next for 4 years to the full master's level. That and the coffee cart in the student hub. Today, I am a senior teacher of deaf students, still employed by Kelston Deaf Education Centre. I manage one of our satellite deaf provisions at Ormiston Senior College in South Auckland. Education continues for me, however. 12 months ago, I started to learn Braille, and in 18 months, I'll also be a qualified teacher of blind children. I want to continue applying these skills to help improve the education and the lives of hearing impaired and visually impaired students across New Zealand for many years to come. This is my passion, and I can truly say I love what I do. I could give you hundreds of examples of success stories with students, but I'll highlight just a couple. Like seeing the sense of achievement on one of my students' faces as he made it to the summit of Rangitoto last year, despite his physical disability as well as his deafness. Or the girl I teach who is both hearing impaired and vision impaired, who after years of trying is now just one step away from getting her NCA level 1 high school qualification. Life doesn't get much better than those moments, watching the kids excel. I think what Unitec really did for me was take me from a job to a career, and it's important to distinguish the two. You can notice the difference when you think about time. With a job, there's often too much time. You watch the clock and you wait for the hours to pass by. But with a career, there's never enough time. You blink and the day is over. With a career, you're swept along by the passion for what you do. I wish each and every one of you the joy and satisfaction in your chosen career that I am lucky enough to experience each day. Well, you haven't come to hear me speak, so I'll begin to close. But if I was going to offer you some advice to take away, I'd only ask you to think about three things. Firstly, the children I teach come from every socioeconomic background, a wide range of cultures, and have all been dealt a tough set of cards in life. One thing I always try to foster in them is an appreciation of each other's differences. We all have our own talents and gifts. Find out what other people's are and celebrate them. Secondly, obstacles will invariably come along in life. I work with some of the most resilient kids you will ever meet, and I often take lessons from them. Your ability to pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and think your way around the tough obstacles when they come along is what will make you truly succeed. Often you cannot get past obstacles alone, and you will need guidance and help. Never be too proud or shy to ask for help. And lastly, kindness. Be kind to everybody. Kindness is a language in itself. How you treat others is a reflection of your character. Help whenever and wherever you can. You will find that being kind revisits you tenfold and gives you as much or more happiness than the people receiving your kindness. So be demonstrative and generous. If you find it hard to say it, write it, or show it with a kind deed. So let me leave you with the reminder that you are graduating from a world-class tertiary institution. Be immensely proud to be Unitec graduates. I am. On behalf of all the proud onlookers, a massive congratulations to you all, the class of 2014. Thank you.
Ai aku nui, ai aku rahi, nau mai, hare mai. Ki roto I tō tātō nei whakaruruho mō tērā nei. He whakanuia ēnei a tātō nei a konga. Tēnā koutou, kia ora tātou katoa. Well, a very, very warm welcome to each and every one of you. My name is Rick Eade, and I'm Unitec's Chief Executive. To our graduates, diplomates, and certificate recipients, this is your day. We celebrate with you, we salute you, enjoy it. To family, friends, whānau, loved ones, thanks for coming along and sharing in the party. To colleagues, staff of Unitec, our distinguished guest, and to our new Council Chair, Dr. Lee Mathias, with her first graduation ceremony with us at Unitec. A very warm welcome to you, Lee. And of course, to our guest speaker, Saul. From my perspective, I think Saul has, in his speech, personified everything that we aspire to for our graduates, everything we aspire to as an organisation to help add to your learning journey, to help you, whether you are joining the workforce for the first time, maybe changing your career or extending and building on your career. So Saul, thank you for those words, and what you do is truly inspiring. So as Saul said, this is all about you, it's not about speeches, so I won't be very long, and just a few bits and pieces to attend to before we get started. So to our graduates, you when you go out to the next step in your journey, you are our reputation. You are the face of Unitec. It is what we have been able to help you achieve that is basically what represents us as an organisation, and we are just so proud of you. We hope, though, that this isn't the end of our relationship with you. Whether you might at some stage in the future come back to take the next step, please join our alumni group, and who knows, in the future you might yourselves be able to help a future Unitec graduate take their first step into a new career. But please do stay in touch. Now, to friends, family, whānau, loved ones, we're here in these in sort of these fantastic surroundings, wearing our sort of nice academic regalia and our silly hats. And you come into these events and these venues, and often there's sort of rules and regulations posted around about no video recording, please keep quiet, all of that sort of stuff. Well, I'm very pleased to tell you that today none of those rules apply. So please make sure you celebrate appropriately for for whoever it is you're cheering for. Take photos, cheer, stamp, cheer, whatever you like. Haka, that's fine. Now, We've got a few official bits that we need to move on to now, so could I please ask everybody graduating today to stand up? So, Chair of Council, it is my pleasure to advise you that all those standing before you today and those graduating in absentia have satisfied all of the criteria required for the qualifications that they are being awarded and the Academic Board have so certified. The Council of Unitec, in accordance with the Education Act 1989, may grant them the awards listed in the program. Thank you. Thanks, you can sit down again now. Okay, on to the important part. As Saul said, take it easy across the stage, it'll all go just fine, you'll be guided on your way. Please make sure your trip up the stairs is conducted in an upright fashion, just take it easy on those stairs. And it's now my great pleasure to introduce our first reader to start proceedings, Sue Gascoigne, our Head of Nursing. Sue.
We have a senior scholar graduating today. The Senior Scholar Award is made to graduates of undergraduate degrees who consistently achieve exceptional grades during their course of study. A taonau will be presented as the recipient is called for the conferral of the degree. I have much pleasure in presenting to the Chief Executive the diplomates for the Diploma in Enrolled Nursing. Nazia Ali. Elizabeth Apiata. Alisi Kajimavuna. Caroline Cook. Keely Copel. Nolene Dale. Shiwangni Devi. Maria Dustin. Kelvin Fraser. Timasi Kitara. Donna Kneebone. Tarina Kuraya. Estefanos Mogzareya. Epineza Mutimuti. Jasmine Pasha. Gary Rickards. Kelly Scrimger. Savita Singh. Laura Stewart. Anna Telefoni. Carol Terrell. Jake Watson. Judith Wilson. I now present to the Council Chair the graduands for the Bachelor of Health Science, Medical Imaging. Rebecca Clark. Nicole Engelbretson. Haley Hamilton. Pashantho K. Naratram. Julie Marie Southern. I now present the graduands for the Bachelor of Nursing. Lisa Chaplow. Collins Ndango Nialam. Gemma Cook. Gemma is also receiving the Certificate in Foundation Studies Level 3 for Tinga. Dilnor Kaur. Olivia Hamill Cunningham. Laura Highton. Grace Mangnall. Joseph McCormick. Yashmin Muhammad Ali. Terry Richards. Stephanie Stanley. Nicola Summerfield. Sui Mei Chi. Margaret Vertag. I now present the graduands for the Master of Osteopathy with second class honours, Leanne Jeffries. With second class honours, Catherine Major. With second class honours, Amanda Smythe. Andrew Duffy. Callum Farquharson. Graciela Gregorio. Nicholas Ritter. Bradley Timberlake. I now present to the Chief Executive the Diplomate of the Diploma in Veterinary Nursing, Alexandria Gibson. I now present to the Council Chair the graduand for the Bachelor of Applied Science, Animal Management and Welfare, and Biodiversity Management, Olivia Colenso. I now present the graduands for the Bachelor of Applied Science, Animal Management and Welfare, Sarah Jolly. Janice Lang Yin Chi. Chai Tan. I now present the graduands for the Bachelor of Applied Science, Biodiversity Management. Oran Ur. Shannon Marks. Margaret Wade. Jordan Winiata. I now present to the Chief Executive the recipients of the Certificate in Community Skills. Hazel Aloisi. Summer Coneybear. Patrice Cooper. Sean Jones. Natasha Hola. Wally Lee. Te Rangimarie McNeil. Emily Save. Sefton Smith. I now present the diplomates of the Graduate Diploma in Not-for-Profit Management. Stephen Lapsley. Meritiana Lolesio. I now present the diplomate of the Postgraduate Diploma in Counselling. Weehinga Chase. I now present the diplomate of the Postgraduate Diploma in Social Practice. Neha Muknatala. I now present to the Council Chair the graduands for the Master of Social Practice. With First Class Honours, Yolanda Mema. With First Class Honours, Lisa Woolley. With Second Class Honours, Flora Nazari. I now present to the Chief Executive the diplomates of the Diploma in Sport and Fitness Education. Felicity Bray. Anzac Simi. I now present to the Council Chair the graduands for the Bachelor of Sport Coaching. Javed Ali. Kevin Charlie. Jude Jeans. Suk Ju. I now present the graduands for the Bachelor of Sport Management. Alexander Cox. Samuel Runicles. I now present the graduands for the Bachelor of Sport, Physical Education. Adrian Carbonilla. Jethro Friend. Jeremy Party. Tara Salt. Pili Salu. Tadil Tech Il Haimanot. I now invite Dr. Elizabeth Rainsbury, Head of Department Accounting and Finance, to present the next awards.
I have much pleasure in presenting to the Chief Executive the recipients of the Certificate of Business Administration and Computing Level 3. Timothy O'Brien. Luatala Sa Utahi A Ana. Luatala is also receiving the Certificate of Business Introductory. Nailon with Haha Archie. I now present the Diplomate of the Diploma in Management, Operations Management, Linda Cassidy. I now present the Diplomate of the Diploma in Professional Accountancy, Praveena Balasubramanian. I now present the recipient of the Graduate Certificate in Professional Accountancy, Diego Jojuela Casayas. I now present the diplomates of the Graduate Diploma in Professional Accountancy, Jasmine Ali. Bhavna Shah. I now present the diplomates of the New Zealand Diploma in Business, Georgina Campbell. Luke Christensen. Sarala Gurusan. Svetlana Maltsevol. Svetlana is also, she is also receiving the Diploma in English Academic. Claudine Marita. Sua Noah Malali, Salata Ioani. Elizabeth Simmons. Mark Speedy. Tori Tapusoa. Xu Xuan Shou. Shan Shan Zhang. Yui Chun Zhang. I now present the Diplomate of the Diploma in Tourism, Leadership and Management, Lisa Croft. I now present to the Council Chair the graduands for the Bachelor of Business, Accountancy and Finance. I will now present the Tuanga to our Senior Scholar, Wendy Hawkes. Thank you. Yui Lin. Jerong Guo. Xu Wen Xiao. Zhen Huang Xin. I now present to the Council Chair the graduands of the Bachelor of Business Accountancy, Raywin Adams. Thirindu Dizanaika. Tabusam Gandhi. Fang Gu. Lena Han. Aaron Johnston. Madhu Lata. Dan Liu. Shen Jiao Liu. Ran Liu. Rita Patel. Tong Su. Li Xuan Swin. Lu Swin. Maura Thompson. Jonathan Vijay Kumar. Bean Wei. Qian Xu. Hong Yang. Quinn Yu. Chi Yu. Chu Ming Zhang. Xiao Meng Zhou. I now present the graduands of the Bachelor of Business Finance, Ying Chan Liu. Tae Win Young. I now present the graduates for the Bachelor of Business Management. Jonathan Britto. Eli Fa'anunu. Yong Song Pang. Fei San Shaikh. Mohammed Sheblack. Anushka Singh. I now present the graduates for the Bachelor of Business Marketing. Mohammed Awayan. Marwan Halhamden. Jean Luck Lawler. Priyashna Naidu. Tian Wu. I now present to the Chief Executive the diplomates of the Graduate Diploma in Business, Human Resource Management. Claire Fernandez. Edith Holton. Nina Medell. I now present the diplomates of the Graduate Diploma in Business Marketing. Mahia Gaja. Hitesh Nanu. Kim Kit Yim. I now present the diplomates of the Graduate Diploma in Business Operations Management. Nipinda Gill. Jaspreet Singh. Simran Rathore. Aritro Sen. Anuja Tiagi. I now present the diplomates of the Graduate Diploma in Business, Daljeet Kaur. Derek Tunker. Lauren Furry. Karen Gulati. Michelle Rathod. Sindhu Panus. Harsimran Singh. Jare. Silalam Waltney. I now present to the Council Chair the graduates for the Master of Business, Kajit Barapatri. Trudy Bridges. I now present to the Chief Executive the recipients of the Certificate in Communication and Media Arts, Caleb Ruckerty. Jack Wallace. I now present to the Council Chair the graduate for the Bachelor of Communication Honours, Stephen Elmers. I now present the graduates for the Bachelor of Communication, Event Management and Public Relations, Siobhan Belling. Shanti Marsh. Charlie Mills. I now present the graduate for the Bachelor of Communication, Event Management, Georgia Lynham. Georgia is also receiving the Certificate in Communication and Media Arts. I now present the graduates for the Bachelor of Communication, International Communication, Samuel Slater. Nicholas Sykes. I now present the graduands for the Bachelor of Communication Public Relations, Genevieve Hines. Jesse McDermott. I now present to the Chief Executive the diplomates of the Postgraduate Diploma in International Communication, Pooja Gulk. Chiel Mung Ma. I now present to the Council Chair the graduand for the Master of International Communication, Rezvangul Nur Muhammad, with second class honours. She's also getting that with second class honours, and as well is receiving the graduate certificate in English as an additional language. I now present to the Chief Executive the recipients of the Certificate in Computer Servicing, Sione Penilatu. B.J. Singh. I now present the diplomates of the Diploma in Applied Computer Systems Engineering, Nigel Chandra. Philip Davies. Robert Nanaya Karu. Mariano Santangelo, I now present the diplomates of the Diploma in Information Technology Support, Thomas Braddock. Guide. Yash Jogia. I now present to the Council Chair the graduands for the Bachelor of Computing Systems, Carly Allen. Farhad Alotaibi. Abdul Aziz bin Hassan. Amon Cottle Houston. Gaja. Nathan Ganley. Ismail Math. Pratish Mistry. Chien Nyan. Jay Panjoli. Vishal Patel. Sushant Sharma. Jaspal Singh. Matthew Trotman. Kanga Yogeswaran. I now present to the Chief Executive the diplomates for the Graduate Diploma in Computing. Anvar Ashkayov. And Kit Bodar. Renato Di Mandonca. Tondarai Gorm. Shi Li Huang. Nadan Sharaf. Tula Kuma Kavya. Dennis Kasarog. Dimitri Orlov. Brett Parr. Sujay Serikov. Kawajot Sadu. Lee Tiong. I now present the diplomates of the postgraduate diploma in computing, Ravi Chabra. Hardeep Kaur. Rashita Kohli. Manpreet Kaur. Pavel Perunan. Jignesha Kumar Patel. Razika Ranawaka Arachi Yee. Sabaya Saini. Ritu Sharma. I now present to the Council Chair the graduands for the Master of Computing. And with First Class Honours, Bernd Martin. Shane Randall Kaka. I have much pleasure in presenting to the Council Chair the graduate for the Doctor of Computing, Lei Song.
Well done, Lei Song. Lei Song's thesis title is Spatiotemporal Incremental Data Modeling for Multidimensional Environmental Analysis. This study discusses multidimensional data analysis approaches for various environmental applications. One such application is the detection of the illegal appropriation of public land in Auckland, which has the potential to enable local government to monitor sustainable resource use and promote environmental protection within Auckland's boundaries. Another application examined by Lei Song's thesis is the detection and examination of indoor pollutants. It is notable that although most people are primarily concerned with pollution outdoors, research shows that we should think about pollutants within our own homes, from cooking, electronic equipments, air conditioning, and other household appliances. The work also examines the problems associated with the collection and use of outdoor air quality data. These data are notoriously difficult to collect, and this thesis proposes some novel and innovative uses of computational intelligence to do this. This research advances existing technologies for environmental analysis in these areas, namely land usage and in air quality, indoor and outdoor. Well done, Lei Song.
Finally, I also acknowledge those graduating in absentia.
Fantastic ceremony and congratulations, team. You've got the prize for the most number of on-stage selfies we've ever achieved. So. You should feel proud of yourselves for more than just that, however, for your achievement, for marking the moment. It's absolutely terrific. And for all of us as a staff at Unitec, our graduation ceremonies mark something really special. It marks a moment where we see and recognise and celebrate your success. And so I'd like to ask my colleagues, the staff of Unitec here on stage, to stand and acknowledge your success. Thank you, team. And we also know that many of you, if not all of you, didn't make this journey alone, and that here in the room today are friends, family, whānau, loved ones who have helped you on that journey in many and varied ways. So why don't all of you here today graduating, stand up, turn around, face them and say what you think. Okay, we're almost there. So in a moment, our student president will give the valedictory address, and then we'll have Hare and Claire will come up with the karakia and to bless the food, and then we'll have a performance by our very own Unitec music students, and we'll conclude by standing and singing the national anthem. So it gives me now great pleasure to invite our student president, Ben Keevy, to the stage, and I would like to acknowledge that this will be, Ben, your last graduation ceremony as student president before you go off and I think the phrase is get a real job. It's been Ben's on his way to Christchurch hope in the near future for a fantastic career in the construction industry. So Ben, over to you.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, friends and family, and most importantly, to the graduates of 2014. For many of you sitting here today, you'll be able to look back on this time at Unitec and say it's been quite a ride. No doubt there have been some difficult times in your journey of study. Some of you will be choosing to continue that study, while others will be looking in a new direction, to a new journey, down new paths. Wherever your path is heading, success is in sight for those directions as well, I'm sure. People enter into education for many reasons. For some, it's the career prospects. For others, it's personal interests. But whatever your motivations for helping you get here today, you now have achieved that goal. So be proud of it. Study really does take a lot of sacrifice. Many of you have given your time and money to no doubt be able to succeed here today. Maybe your sacrifice was asking your partner to do the housework a little more. Maybe it's promising the flatmates that you'll do the cleaning next weekend, because the assignment's due tomorrow morning. Or if you're like me, maybe it's asking mum and dad to be able to help with the broke student donation fund. In the end, those sacrifices you have made, or mum and dad have made, all add up to helping you get where you are today. As you all move to the next stage of your lives, try to remember something I have learnt. See these people sitting next to you in this room? They really are important. Stay connected with them. Keep in contact. Not just because they'll be able to get you hooked up with the next job in 5 years, but actually because they're your friends in your industry and sector of study for the rest of your life. As a graduate of Unitec myself, I can honestly say signing up for Unitec's alumni program is something to seriously consider. And I still keep in contact with people I studied with. Hey, you never know when the person sitting next to you is going to win lotto. How do they say it? Sharing is caring. All of these people sitting behind me helped get you where you are today. These Unitec staff, they pushed you to achieve amazing success. They supported you when times were tough. And they gave their knowledge and experience to the next generation of professionals, you. So graduates of 2014, I'm going to ask you to stand up now. This is your opportunity to be able to look these Unitec staff in the eye and show you them your appreciation for them helping you achieve amazing success. Stand up, everyone. Show them what they have helped participate in getting you to a stage. Have a seat. As Unitec CEO, Rakeed said before, this will be my last time doing this speech at Unitec. Hopefully, I'll be walking onto the stage for the second time at the end of next year. There are a couple of things that I've come to learn as I became a president. One is the most amazing experience I've ever had at Unitec was actually watching over 2,000 graduates walk across the stage in the time that I've been a president. The other is learning what people are actually willing to do on a stage in front of people. I've seen Gangnam Style, I've seen the Harlem Shake, Huckers. I've now learned that you can actually do selfies on a stage as well. So those people that took those photos, can you pass them on to me? I'll have them viral in about 3 hours. I'd like to finish with a quote that I heard a few weeks ago. It's from Donald Trump. He said, as long as you're going to be thinking big anyway, think amazing. So go forth, Unitec graduates, 2014. Conquer your dreams to come. Congratulations again. You did it. You achieved it. Thank you very much.
The bird that consumes the merry bird, Miroberry, his forest.
Ko te manu ka kai I te matauranga nona te ao.
Bird that consumes knowledge, his is the world.
Ina kia u kia manawa nui, kia whai tonu ngā tinu wawata, tu mana ko hei oranga mau.
Be passionate, be committed to pursuing your dreams as sustenance for your future aspirations.
Nā mihi rangatira ka tau ki runga I a koutou katoa. Kei tua o te pai, ko tōnei ao.
Sincere congratulations to you all. Your destiny is beyond the horizon.
Amen.
Blessing of food.
Nau mai nā hua o Papatua Nuki o Ranganui ke te kai.
I welcome the food from Earth Mother, food baskets of Sky Father.
Whiti ki ora.
Gifts bound together to sustain us all.
Haumie, huie, taikie.
Oh. How does the sun in the sky and the moon in the night? How does the trees give us life to breathe? How does the wind leave its home just to play in the storm? Why does my heart keep on falling in love? It must be love, 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 touching me again. Must be love, 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 again. Must be love, 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 touching me. Summer's not coming around when you're not here by my side. I know that summer's not coming around when you're not.
Thank you. On behalf of me and the boys, we'd just like to congratulate all the graduates that are graduating today. And we're students here at Unitec as well, at the music school. And the song we just sang was just an original. Our next one is an oldie but a goodie. Like I said before, if your feet get a little itchy, please don't be shy to dance. It'll make us feel a little more comfortable anyway. Thank you.
Thank you.
everyone's helping here. I need all the ladies to sing "No Word of Night" with me, okay? On the count of three, all the ladies in the house, I want you to sing with me "No Word of Night." All right? All right, ready to go. One, two. Keep going. All the boys, follow me. Come on, all the gentlemen in the house. All right, we're all going to sing together. One, two, three. Thank you. Congratulations.